Hi guys, welcome back to another action figure review. Today we're going to have a look at Lodar from the Masters of the Universe Classics line. He has just been released in the last couple of weeks and he was produced by Super 7. It's his first time being made into a figure and he is from the mini comic The Slave City, which came out in the 80s. So if you are a mini comic fan like I am, I had mini comics well before I knew the cartoon ever even existed. I wasn't allowed to watch much TV as a kid, so I was more into the comics. I would study these things inside out and was a huge fan. So I'm super excited that Lodar has finally been made into a figure. So this is the back of his box. And there is his bio, if you would like to pause that and have a read. And if we spin around to the front, let's take him out of the box. Okay, so here he is out of the box. As you can see, he's kind of a light pink sort of color. His a pinky purple color is his skin. And then he has this armor on over top. These shoulder pad armors, it looks like a reuse of Beastman's shoulder pads. He comes with this spiked mace. He has these really crazy, amazing spikes under his shoes, which are actually hurt a little bit. They're quite pointy. And again, he just has these standard legs, nothing new that we haven't seen before with these figures. He does have the new wrist articulation that a lot of figures don't have. And that's about it. Again, his head turns. I probably wouldn't try and remove his head just because I don't think Super 7 are doing that these days. And the other accessory he comes with is this chain with the cuffs on it. So the cuffs, they feel like they might be a little bit brittle if you tried to pull them too far. They're just kind of designed to slip over the hands of other characters, so you can do a similar sort of pose to this. So it's a little bit different. This has got two, this is just one with two chains attached. So stick around guys and I will post some photos.